nothing exciting. I'm playing Nasus and Thresh today. My quest is to draw cards, just doing dailies. I'll probably upload this to YouTube later. Okay, I have audio on right now, but I'll probably turn that off later. It's during the week I like to watch streams and stuff, and I don't want to have a whole VOD of streams, but yeah. What am I going to watch? Doesn't look like there's any streams today. Just watch YouTube on the side. Nothing to watch, eh? Okay. That's fine. So, with this deck, I mean, obviously, I want to find Thresh. Am I a mirror match? Okay. Thresh, dig hard. I think I need this because I need something to kill, to draw, and all that stuff. Okay. The right is good. We'll see. Yeah, usual. I'm conflicted with this because I kind of want it for this. I have Who Crushers, but this is a draw anyway, so this is fine. Oh, another Thresh. Okay. Whatever, man. So does the attack. Yeah, cool. Because that was not happening, so. Just play that, say, okay. I can go with this if I need to. Don't really want to, though, but. Just do it because it's gonna die anyway. I'm about to take a ton of damage, which sucks, but what can you do, right? Okay. That's good. Question is, do I do it now or after I play Thresh? I think we have to do it now because this is a lot of damage I'm about to take, so. Fortunate, but what can you do? I mean, you can draw with it. I'm not gonna stop him from that. Don't know why I'm pressing Discord. That's fine. Not much I can do. Okay. I don't think playing Nasus is right. Not yet, anyway. So, if I do that, I'm healing three. This seems right.
There you
Really? Oh, that sucks for me. Let's take a beating. Play this so we can kind of block. I'm just gonna take this threat of this nest to the face, which is gonna hurt. Hopefully, I'm not dead. I think I'm dead. Oh my god. Unlucky. I needed to save the box for when he was attacking. I'm not dead. Oh no, I'm dead. Super. I need to save the box for when he's attacking, not before. I didn't think he'd have a second sapling dude, though. That's what I expected. Wow.
Okay.
I'm really bad at the mirror match.
Summoners, and welcome back to another episode of OP Patch
Okay.
Predictions. I'm
Well,
Tia,
that's
and today we'll be talking
surprisingly
about some of
loud.
the changes coming on
Let's
patch
turn that up.
11.9 and how they may change or fail to change the state of the game. Let's get right into it. We're going to start things off by addressing the changes we're seeing to Hecarim. If you haven't already seen them, here's what's coming up. Hecarim's damage ramp on his Q has been lowered, but the ramping has a bonus AD ratio. So with enough attack damage, you'll be able to eventually be stronger than before. Eventually, W's healing effect now has a bonus AD ratio added onto the percent of damage that Hecarim heals for, but healing from allies' damage is halved. And lastly, Hecarim's E base minimum damage is taking a small
I don't
hit.
keep
the mass damage
Nessus,
taken,
right? This
damage
is
taken
okay.
These changes are
Draws.
definitely easier for the more popular tank Hecarim
I don't
with
know
heal
if I should
ability
take
and
all
Gold Blade.
this
A few nerfs will give him a bit of a boost.
direction.
But don't
Never
take
mind.
this as
I'm
them
messed
buying the
up.
champ. Hecarim is still going to be more than a viable pick. In fact, AD Hecarim will be an even stronger carry in the mid to late stage of
If he
the game,
doesn't
once
play
he gets
anything,
AD
I
to
don't
queue
want
up to
to
and
play
even
anything.
over the previous ramping.
Because I'm playing
A slightly
these
slower clear for a champ that currently has an incredibly fast and healthy clear is still going to leave him better off than most champs. The W change will give you less
Damn
in certain
right.
team fight situations, but it's pretty common to be diving far past the point that your allies can help you anyways as Hecarim. And in those cases, you'll be healing more as you try to bring down the enemy backline. Basically, the takeaway here is that Hecarim is still going to be an S tier pick, potentially even staying as the best pick in the role. This seems sort of like a common thing. Riot is so hesitant about nerfing the round, but they put out nerfs that seem more like a and the champ
Oh,
range for
jeez, I'm sorry.
On the right hand, that champ is still one of the strongest carries in the game, and it seems like she's been that way for like a year now. And that brings us to today's question of the day. What other champs have been too OP for too long? I think a lot of champs follow this, mostly because they're heavily slept on as either unpopular picks, such as Garner, or champs that have their stats skewed due to being hard to play, with first timers and lower skilled players bringing their win rate down, such as Camille. But enough about what I think, I want to know your picks down in the comments below. Okay, so back on topic. Here's a quick breakdown of how the two different builds will be on Hecarim now. Tank Hecarim will have much lower damage than before, and will be easier to bring down since he will receive less healing from his W. But it's still a viable playstyle if you want to be able to engage your team and provide disruption. AD Hecarim will be able to carry much harder than the tank build, but since you won't be as beefy if you don't have the damage to bring down targets, or if you misplay in fights, you'll be susceptible to being blown up. Personally, I think higher risk, higher reward carrying strength is a better sense of balance for a champ like Hecarim. Doing well for well into carrying
okay.
or doing poorly in flopping is much healthier than a champ that can get the best of both worlds by being able to be a hard carry as a tank with no real weakness. If you do
Okay.
have the AD build,
I can't do much about that one.
Carrying your game, it should look something
I
like
want to block
this.
The
Hellblade,
spider.
Trinity Force, Plate of Steel Cap, or Murk Treads, Stair Gate, Dead Dance, and Spirit Visage. Your last item can be situational, but some options are Guardian Angel, Dead Man's Plate, Force of Nature, and Gargoyle Stone Plate. For runes, you'll run Conqueror, Triumph, Tenacity, Last Stand, Nimbus Cloak, and Celerity, with your stat runes being double adaptive force.
This.
The Phase Rush rune page works too, especially
think we
against
do
teams
this?
That explode, but this is for maximum carrying potential in general. Next up for
it's only one
another
damage,
in
right?
This champ is actually on the buff list again, and it's actually a decision we question a lot.
Will.
Back on 11.7, Kendrick was a champ that we considered pretty strong. When you put a hard ceiling
hold
hyper
it.
Marksman in the jungle, they should
because
be able
I
to
want
consistently
this
perform
to
nearly game every single game. Yet, that's exactly what it seems like Riot is pushing for. Kendrick's strength comes from being able to accumulate marks, giving you buffs to each
so
ability,
now
and increased
I kill
range
it.
At certain
okay.
thresholds. Like I said earlier in the video, hard
See,
carry champs should be
huge
high risk,
break.
High reward. With Kendrick, failing to acquire stacks should leave you a liability for your team. While doing well early and securing marks should allow you to be an incredibly strong carry. This could be broken down and argued about in many ways, but it's my opinion that this type of baseline buff for a champ like Kendrick is
Does he get,
best. If you're going to buff her,
minion
buff her
still?
Away rewards good players for securing marks, i.e. buffs to the effects that marks give her abilities. She
yep.
shouldn't be getting buffs that simply make her a better champ no matter what choices you make in the game. If you're interested in actually being able to abuse an OP pick like Kendrick, like I said, you'll need to know what you're doing. She isn't the type of carry that can just AFK farm and then you're just winning the game. You need to be able to secure marks, and doing that means having a really strong sense of which marked camps you can contest, when it's safe to invade for one, when you have to give one up, and knowing which lanes are best to gank for easy stacks. Doing this well means you can easily carry fights, but if you don't have a clue on how to pass, you'll find yourself being useless game after game. Trust me, we've all been there, and it can be pretty hard to understand these tough concepts like this on your own, but thankfully, we've got your back. At ProGuides.com, our top tier coaches are ready to help you with all of your needs. So whether you need help with basic concepts and general guidelines like how to pass, or more advanced specific things, head on over and book your session now so you can level up your skills
right.
and start climbing that ladder.
Let's,
Much like Kendrick, Lulu is a champion buff that we already have as a top tier pick.
Another one?
I love Lulu, she is bae, but she is pretty easy to play, especially she's an enchanter
tough.
That pretty much anyone can pick up and use, and she's statistically doing well as it is. So why is she being buffed? Maybe there just hasn't been enough space for sales. It's not that the buff is that huge or anything,
Oh
but a buff is a buff. off. And with Lulu already being S tier at sport and being pretty much tied with Janna for the spot of number one enchanter in the game, it's just kind of crazy to see her somehow being targeted for buffs. But honestly, I'm not complaining because I'm trying to get diamonds. So keep
this
on.
This is really good later.
The jungle ecosystem, there's a pretty notable nerf. Okay, Temtem having its movement speed active being slashed from a 60% buff down to 40%. This isn't going to completely remove the item from the game, as it will remain a core piece for someone like Storm, but it definitely cuts down on the general concept of a dominant speed demon meta we currently see, where people simply walk in a tank with any type of engage and build Temtem tank with other tanky movement speed items and not the enemy team with the press of a button. I think this playstyle is like snooze fest. It's so boring with many junglers as well as top laners being able to basically play on autopilot and still have the guarantee of being useful in fights thanks to their engage rank. So I'm honestly glad to see this nerf. No more being outdone by jungle player 375 who walks in a tank, gives out half of them outganked, but wins because they can build Temtem tank on all their other
teams. How do I kill my units?
So what champs will benefit from this nerf? This is basically an indirect buff to any high ganking champ that wants to snowball early and close the game out fast, as well as other scaling champs who opt for more of a carry role in team fights. With a slight Sunfire buff being pushed out on the same patch, there are some junglers that don't even use Temtem tank well who will become pretty powerful picks. So with all that said, basically every non-Temtem tank jungler will be better, with the most notable OP picks being those that are already very strong, like Fiddle, Elise, and Rek'Sai.
We just go wide.
In the role, since they fall into the minority of tanks that don't have Temtem tank as it is. Before we end things, I just want to say that I'm a wee bit disappointed with this patch. The whole thing is just kind of resident sleeper. Looking at the buff list, no champ is getting a change big enough to warrant a change to their position on the tier list. Take Trundle, for example. Trundle is good against tanks.
I think that's the right play to go wide.
An increase to the slow from his E will make him slightly better when he's already good, but it isn't going to make him suddenly good where he was previously bad. Xerath having more poke
games
is going to be the threat of being jumped on and one-shot. Full-on poke comps haven't been a thing for some time, simply because hard engage and or assassins are pretty much always in the meta, both of which Xerath is terrible against. In the rare case you end up against neither, he can definitely carry, and this buff will help. But those games are too few and far between to call him an OP pick. Pretty much every other buff on the list falls into this. If the champ was good in the situation before, they'll be better, and if they weren't, you won't suddenly be inclined to lock them in. Looking at the nerfs, we sort of see the same lack of meaningful changes. We already talked about how OP Hecarim is going to continue to be, and every other nerf seems to be pretty much
about any of that.
As with Hecarim, a lot to the clear speed on Morgana and Diana, who are in the ridiculous
maybe go wide earlier.
Is still going to leave them on the high upper end of clear speed. Rumble and Baron are two dominant picks in both solo lanes at the moment, and both of their so-called nerfs are so microscopic that they probably won't really change the outcome of any games at all. Not only are these nerfs light in scale, but they also seem pretty misplaced. As I brought up with the question of the day, many champs go months at the top without being nerfed, and this patch is no exception.
Here, we'll mute the audio because you don't know what I'm watching. Okay, so all I do is lose. I may not like these, but... it's good leading up to Thresh, so I'll keep it, but... Okay, that's fine. Play this to block that, I guess. This on three. Oh my god. Alright. Hope he doesn't have zero. He doesn't, but he did that, so. Alright, so this turn, I want to play this, but I don't really care about it attacking. This is kind of, this attack is kind of cool, though. It doesn't do that much, though. It's like one damage. So we'll do this. Just make this one on this. Okay. Oh, that's gonna suck for me. Draw, it's pretty good. It's gonna suck because these could quite me, but oh well. Can't do it before Thresh comes out. This obviously. And then what are you doing, Chief? That? Oh, I blocked that obviously. Do I do this? I'm an idiot because this, these two up this, but whatever. I mean, this is the same. It's a little worse, obviously. I'm an idiot, though. Okay. This, am I plopping this down? I don't think so. I think I'd rather draw. So, plopping down Thresh, obviously. So we try for this. attack with this to try and get damage on that. That's fine. It dies, that's what I want. So, what am I doing here? Am I just sending this? Don't really have a choice. Okay, cool. Oops, doing this, obviously. This end of this is pretty good. If I do this into this, that is killing 3 units, which isn't enough. I mean, it is enough because I want to get the Nasus going. So I'm going to go for this. It's really weird, but I'm trying to force Nasus here. I'm really happy with that because you're the one who attacked. So I'm on the attack now. So I get Nasus, but my Nasus is weaker. So that's fine. You can still play a unit though, which kind of blows, but it's whatever. Nasus. Do I just play a Nasus? No, I don't think so. Did he pull himself? This is another, so I don't think he can pull himself. Don't know what he can do here. I mean, if he runs the kill card, there's nothing I can really do about it. I need 10 mana. We're going to be at 8. Plus 3. 8 plus 3 is how much? 11. So technically I have enough. I'm gonna play this to this and to that, so. I mean, I guess. And then use this or whatever if he tries to do anything about this. kind of figured it out this game. Basically, the way to play the matchup is get Thresh before your opponent. Not necessarily on the board, but get Thresh to use his ability. All the time, that means not attacking. You're all good. Okay, that blows. Start is gross. What can you do? All right, here we go. Boom. Oh my God. It's not the one I wanted, but whatever. About to do that to this? Maybe. Wow, this is a clunky hand, man. Which I can do, so no, useless. Useless. Oh, okay, this is probably the clunkiest hand I've ever seen with this deck. I think this is just donezo. That's too much damage. Do I want to get rid of this? That's what I don't know. Do I want to kill this? Kinda. It's kind of weird, but I think it's right. So then my next turn is this into this, I think. And then play this. Of course. He's gonna discard it, but unless my play is like this. I guess. That's fine. Stop damage. So he's gonna use that to level Jinx, but I gotta do this. So he can throw out the card and level Jinx, but Jinx is still dead. That's what I care about right now. So send this. He technically can't block it, but obviously he's gonna spinning axe. Oh, I'm s surprised he went to my unit for that, but all right. Taunt him, obviously. I'm just dead though. That's good, actually good. If I could get it off, then sure, but there's no way I get that off. So I just play this, I think. If I could get this plus this, that's disgusting, but I don't think he's gonna let me. Yeah, so we go for this play. I guess I could have done this on that, but I think that isn't good enough. Hard to say. Okay. Interesting, interesting. So obviously it's gonna discard and buff their attack, but can't really do much about that. It's only one damage. Is four damage? Oh no, he's gonna nuke me next turn. Okay. I mean that's next turn though, right? Oh no, it is this turn. Because why does it work like that, dude? That's so dumb. Because you level, then you get cards, and then you can do it this turn. So sad. Round start. Each round, the first time you empty your hand. Well, he already emptied his hand the first time, he got to do it again. So that's so stupid. I don't know. I don't think it should work the first turn it goes, but I mean it's a cool interaction, I guess. It's a neat interaction, but the way the card is worded, it shouldn't really make too that much sense, right? Has the way the card is worded, the first time you discard your hand, you get it. Well, he already discarded his hand once, so why does he get to do it again? Right, so I want Yeah, I'm okay with all of this. Second Thresh, not so much, but it's okay. This is the 5 attack deck. He's going to rally. Oops. Shit. That's fine. Nope, it doesn't work. So, do I want to draw a minion or this? I think we save it for this because that's 2 cards. Happen? Well, it's still dead, so. Wow. I mean, it doesn't matter. Right, well, we're gonna give it a shot. It's probably dead, but we'll give it a go. Yikes, that's gonna suck, but what can you do? How to do this? I'm dead. Yeah, there's not really anything I can do. If I pulled that, no. Not doing well today. I think this is degree, maybe. Mirror? Mirror. Okay. I just take the damage, I don't care. Alright, so from here, this is pretty good. Look at all these thresh. This is good enough. Okay, never mind. Just take damage, I think is the plan. Because if I do this, they just get both taunted. So just take damage is the plan here. I'm okay with that. The other play I could have done is this, which actually isn't that bad. I could have done that. Yeah, I should have done that. It's okay. Too late, obviously. So yeah, I just took extra damage for no reason. Fog. From here, if I attack, I lose these. I don't think I want to attack. I can like reduce this and do some mini trade. We'll see what he plays, but I think it's taunt this. Maybe I swing. I don't know. It's hard to say with these. I do want to clear these so he doesn't have many things to kill as well. All right. Interesting. That doesn't really do that much for me. Let's just send it. Let's clear the board, baby. So I do not want him to have units to kill. And then this being up is fine. I'm going to have 8 mana next turn. Perfect. I'm good with that. I'm not so good with that. Do I take 3? Never mind. That's fine. Okay. Do it, Chief. So from here. See what he does. 'Cause I want to kill 3 units. I don't think it's possible. That's 2. So I don't think we can afford to do this. Try to bait him. He didn't take it. Attack with this. Because why not? I could have taunted this. Actually, that would have been the right play. It's okay.
Really?
Okay, I'm okay with that. mistake here. But what can you do? That is even weirder of a play. Okay, he's just forcing his thresh. Not much I can do, right? Because I can't cancel. This isn't a spell that I can cancel, unfortunately. I mean, I can cancel that. So kill an ally. This is weird, but it makes sense to me. Because it stops two units from dying. So only one unit is dying here. Two units are dying here, so this thresh is not active yet. Holy moly, this is complicated. Okay. Hi. Is it? Oh yeah. That's okay. I don't know. I just didn't look. Yeah, that's
How are
fine.
you doing? The minute,
Yeah.
open the big screen now,
What
like
do you
a
mean?
small screen.
Did I just do for this game? Okay, so from here, kill this. Oh, that's really bad, actually. Yeah, so if he does that, I can. I'm happy with that. I'm okay with that. I'm okay with that. Does it level my guy? I don't know how it works, honestly. It's not. Okay. Yeah, I should play it though, right? The only problem is I need one more damage, but it's okay. Okay. All right. Take it. There another play I could have done? I don't If I played the Nasus. I think what I did was the right play, Because it gives me an out in the scenario he does that. Although if he has the perfect hand, I can't do anything. Okay. Think this one's a little too greedy to keep. So these two into this is fine. Karma locks. I'm happy with that. He plays, of course. Yeah. I do not do this right now. It's fine. So from here, yeah, that's good. We're gonna go straight for it. Let's just go for this. And then we can attack, because if he doesn't block with this, he's taking a lot of damage. Probably blocks with this. Which is fine. He doesn't have enough mana to detain right now, so. That's a good thing. I don't care about the three damage. What is it? Detained 5 mana. Okay. How much room? I don't have enough room for everything. I have to kill one of these. Get this out of here. I don't want detain, right? That barrier I don't care about, so I do not want him to detain me at all. How much damage does this do? Okay, well, what can you do? I can do this. This means it's gonna die though, but then detain isn't an option. This dying. So we have 1, 2, 3 units dying. I already have two Nasuses in my hand. All right, let's do it this way. I do not want detain being an option for him. Unfortunately, this is being blasted for sure. Nothing I can really do about it. Other thing I can do, kill. So nothing I can do, just let it happen. Sorry, my poor Thresh. You're gone, my friend. I could just play Nasus. I have to wait, I think. So let's do this and hold because. Oh, okay with that. Wait, what happened to the barrier? Okay, just play Nasus. He's probably gonna blast it, that's fine with me. Okay, let's do. God damn. Sure, another Nasus, okay. So the problem I have right now is my hand is very clunky. It doesn't have to be Nasus when I do this. Could be this into that. Let's go for it anyway. This is fine. I see. Okay, well, too bad for me. Don't really see the point because it's just blocked, so. I could have done this, but that seems bad. This seems okay. This hand is so clunky, man. What am I supposed to do? All right, can see none of these die. Well, that kind of blows. I don't think I play it now. We're screwed. That, I don't know. That hand was clunky. This deck gets some clunky stuff, man. What am I supposed to do when my board is full? Jeez, another bad day, eh? do I do this? There's no way, right? No, there's no way I play this for four. I mean, my hand's so clunky, I guess so. What is going on? This is so bad. What? I guess, like, I don't know, man. What? Sure, man. I don't know, man. Let's go. What is this hand, dude? It's only things that kill each other. I don't want to kill my heroes. Jeez. Okay. I'm okay with that. Oh Why, dude? Do I kill Nasus? I think I kill Nasus. That's how bad this is. Holy moly. Sure. I'm killing Nasus. That's how bad this hand is. Holy moly. See what we can do here. So I gotta do this into this or this. Is my dream play, but the helpless doesn't die. I can't believe I had to kill Onassis. I mean, I didn't have to, but like my hand is so clunky, man. Try it again. No, that's okay, Chief. To play this, but it's okay. So from here, then I get Nasus, right? So yeah, boom. How big is Nasus? 9. Take it. Okay. How do I kill that? I mean, I could send it. That seems bad. Let's just do I? I mean, if I kill it, what is he gonna do? I'm greedy. This is probably too greedy, but I need to kill this, right? Let's play. Interesting. You gonna pump this? Like, what's the plan here, guy? I haven't faced a Karma deck in a long time, so I don't know what the plan is. Okay. I mean, obviously, I can't do it. What do you, I don't know what this guy wants, dude. What do you want? Okay. Sure. Oh, I see. Do. Okay, RNG Pog, Hearthstone Pog. So from here we can that or this. I think I actually go for this because then it's forcing Karma to die. I mean, actually, he didn't have enough to block, so the other way would have worked a little better, but this is fine. I think I'm just dead, though. I don't have any way to hit him in the face now. Because I was greedy with the killing of this, so now he's punishing me. I don't have any way to kill this, so that could be a problem later as well. One, two, 17. Has no way to heal. I think I'm dead. Wish to? He recalled an ally. Okay. I mean, he's gonna revive his karma, obviously. Don't know. Okay. Not much we can do. I mean, as soon as he finds, it's like whatever that spell is called, the KDA spell. I'm pretty dead. He just needs to. Oh my, yeah. I think that's it, Chief. There. One. Unless he has two in his. I don't know why he's doing it like this. Unless he has a bunch in his hand right now. That's kind of weird because he should be playing it with Karma. Yeah, that's fine. Don't have the box, so it doesn't matter. That's good. It's not that hard, guy. Just keep playing, go hard. Unless you don't have it, then unlucky. What is this? Toss three heals. Sure, man. Yeah, dude. All right, here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Just go. See what happens. Take this. This. See if that does it. Whoops. See, maybe he buffs that, but I doubt it. Yeah. Done with my dailies, I think. For this game. Time to move on to the next one. Baby. How'd I do today? Pretty bad, I think. I went about even in the end. So, with that, we edit. We are going to Hearthstone next.